suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Don't stop. forgive me for saying so, Mrs. Mushkin, but perhaps what the firm needs is to move into a new direction.
But see what's trying to say, Mrs. Mushkin, is, well, we've talked about it and we both agree. Seymour, why don't you go to the back and bring out that strange, interesting new plant you've been working on? You see, Mrs. Mushkin, some of those exotic plants Seymour's been taking around are really unusual. And we were both thinking that maybe some strange and interesting plant commonly displayed in advertising would attract business.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling too well today.
There! Now, isn't that bizarre? At least, what kind of weird plant is that, Seymour?
Well, it looks like some sort of flytrap or something, but I can't find it in any of my books. So, I gave it my own name. I call it an Audrey 2.
After me?
I hope you don't mind. You see, I mean, if you display a strange and interesting plant like this, like on the window over there,
Maybe what? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't just suddenly,
excuse me, I've been noticing that strange and interesting plant. What is it?
It's an Audrey 2.
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Where did you get it?
Well, do you remember that total eclipse of the sun we had a few weeks ago?
Da-doo.
I was walking in the wholesale flower district that day.
Da-doo.
And I went by this place where this old Chinese man,
Chang Da-doo,
he usually sells me strange and exotic plants.
Snip Da-doo.
Because he knows, you see, that strange plants are my hobby. And there was a strange humming sound, like something from another world.
Done.
And when this light came back, this weird plant was just sitting there.
Good seeing you.
Just stuck in, you know, among the cities. I could have sworn it hadn't been there before, but the old man sold it to me anyway. Audrey, but they just given you sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing. But heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly. I'm down on my knees. Now please throw for me. I've given you plenty and water to sip. I've given you potash. You've given me. I'm supposed to, you're barely alive. I tried to run levels of moisture from desert to mud. I've given you fertilizers and mineral supplements. What do you want from me, blood?
Damn roses. Damn thorns.
How long do you mean?
Dewey, look what I did. Hey, you opened up. What made you do that?
He was a hero just above. He was a
be on time.
The button, don't tell me.
You got tied up.
No, just handcuffed a little.
Girl, I don't know who this mess is you're hanging out with, but he is hazardous to your health.
That's for sure, but I can't leave him.
And why not?
He'd get angry. If he does this to me when he likes me, imagine me do if he ever got mad.
So dump the truck and get another guy and let him protect you.
And we got one all picked up.
A little botanical genius.
And she ain't talking about no George Washington Carver.
Seymour? Bingo. Oh, I could never be Seymour's girl. I've got a pass.
Stand a whole month with us.
He says not.
Oh, I don't deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
This job
suffers from both selfish.
You have a point.
She has a problem.
Thank you.
We need refrigeration in our newly improved display, so we're called for renovation.
Yes, indeed. This is the story you heard about Auntie Anne by you. Yes, the attitude on display is good for you.
Okay, you win, I'll be your son.
Hooray, I'll be my son.
Roll up the papers, Mama, touched, I really am. And when you're reading 83, I'll let you come move in with me.
Where?
I promise.
What is that?
I'm a black usual.
You didn't have nothing. You bet me. Come on, kid. What'll it be? Money? Girl. One particular girl. How about that all dress? Mm-hmm. Think it over. There must be some good things. It's real quiet like. And give me some lunch.
Now
while he's gassing himself to a palpable stupor, the timing's ideal and the moment is super to ready and fire and blow the sick bastard away. Now, do it now. Just a little refresher right here on the trigger, and Audrey won't have to put up with that grief for another day. Now, for the girl. Now, for the plant. Now, yes, I will. But I can't. Oh, boy, now. Food, the things we're gonna do with your mouth. Well, I guess I'm bad enough with this stuff now. I'll take the mask off, man. Guess what?
What?
It's stuck.
What?
The mask. It's stuck. Please, I could just asphyxiate here. Come on, Seymour. Give me a hand.
Well.
Well. He says, well. Seymour, I don't think you understand. Don't be blue. I should give. Let them set me happy. Don't. Guys,
what we have here is an ethical dilemma. Unless I help him get the mask room, he doesn't have a prayer. True, the gun was never fired, but the way he mentions fired, I can finish him with simple as a fair. What we have here is a tricky moral problem. Should I help remove the mask or let him go for a conveyor? True, when I tried, but the fates are on my side, I can often die by sitting in the chair.
Thank you. son's first name, Boris. Please hold.
Now you're safe.
Now let's go around for stars.
Love and more in entourage.
Love to the funeral home.
Leaving from St. Andrew's Roman Catholic Church at night and bond. First thing in the morning, you'll be there in the morning.
Suddenly, evil is sad.
Omega. Don't have to pretend. Suddenly, see more. Sweet understanding. See more's your friend.
Nobody ever treated me kind. Daddy left early. Mom was born. I meet a man and I follow him blindly. He snap his fingers at me. I say sure.
You've
got no place to hide.
Dance over.
You've got nowhere to run. She knows your life up front. I think it's overtime.
Seymour baby doll. been trying to reach you, baby. Have your phones been busy? Did you get our telegram?
I don't think so, no.
Well, it's a good thing I came down here then, in person. William Morris Agency. Hey! Forget the cable we sent you. It says you made me the pleasure of yours. Now let my firm represent you. We wanna book you on lecturing tours. College campus Rotary clubs. The kind of bookings my office can do. Show up, let them talk, answer questions. It's educational, lucrative too. My future's starting. I've got to let it stick with the flat and G. My bank account will thrive. What am I saying? No, wait, forget it. It's much too dangerous to keep that plant up. I take these offers, that means more killing. Who knew success would come with a messy, nasty screen? I sign these contracts, that means I'm willing to keep on doing bloody, awful, nasty things. If life were tawdry and impoverished as before, she may not like me, she may not want me. Without my flat, she may not love me
a week ago.
Look, just hold out for one more night, all right? Light Magazine will be here in the morning to take our picture.
And then you'll find somebody?
Then I'll be dead. I promise.
Talk to see you.
talking to you.
I don't believe this.
Believe it, baby. It's talk.
Am I dreaming this?
No, and you ain't in Kansas, neither.
Something's very wrong here.
With your sweetheart.
A favor?
I need some water in the worst way. Look at my branches. I'm a goner, honey. Come on and give me a drink.
I don't know if I should.
Hey, little lady, we
bigger hula hoops?
much bigger.
Every household in America? Thousands of you. Eating. That's what you've had in mind all along, isn't it?
No slack, Sherlock.
But we're not just talking one hungry plant here. We're talking about world conquest.
And I want to thank you.
You're a monster, and so am I.
Baby!
You ain't the only thing I ever loved.
Too bad.
Yeah? Well, take that. And that. And that.
You're incredible.
Well, that didn't work.
Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed, similar events in I'd like to thank a lot of people for helping with this production. I think the first people I'd like to thank is all of you for coming, because when we first decided to restart the tradition of putting on shows here at Corpus Christi, the one fear was, are people going to come? And you've taken care of that fear, and I really thank you for coming. So. Hard work went into this with so many people, and I couldn't begin to thank every one of them up here tonight, but we're just going to highlight a couple of people. First of all, Somi is the youth minister here at church, and she just did so much. There's so many things I just, being because I work, I just couldn't take care of things, and I get on the phone with Somi, and she's so good, we have this to do, we have that to do. A couple hours later, I was taken care of, and that was just such a big help to me. So, Somi, please come on up here.
Videotape, and I don't know.
don't know where Mrs. Stack is, but thank you so much.